Hello everyone, welcome to HelloBridge. In this video, I will go through the different types of recordings in UiPath.
Recordings. UiPath Studio includes a recording feature that can help you save time when automating your business process. This feature allows you to easily capture and translate users' actions on the screen into sequence. There are six types of recordings: basic, desktop, web, image, native Citrix, and compute vision. In this tutorial, let's start with the basic and desktop recording. Basic recording. Basic. For each activity, a full selector is generated with no container. The resulting automation is slower than one that uses containers and is designed for a single task. In the following practical demo, I will explain what is selector and container. Go to UiPath Studio, create a new process, name as recordings, and provide the description as this project is about practical demo of basic and desktop. Then click create. Your studio is ready. Click on open main workflow link on the workflow designer panel, or press Ctrl+Shift+T. Leave this main page and create a new sequence. Go to new and select sequence. Let's start with the basic recording. Provide the sequence name as basic. Then click create. Now your sequence is ready. Before we start recording, open a notepad on your desktop, because I wish to automate several tasks in the notepad. Yes, the notepad is ready. My manual process here is, I want to write something on the notepad, then I want to make a different font style and size of the sentence using format menu font option. Let's start automate this process by the bot. Go to design ribbon tab in the wizard group, select recording. Here you can see the different types of recording. Select basic recording options. Once you select a recording option, the basic recording toolbar is displayed and the main studio view is minimized. There are many actions you can see in this toolbar. These actions used for manually record single actions as you want. Click record option. The automatic recording process started. Now you start automating your process step. Go to notepad. If you move your cursor around notepad, you will notice that the bot is highlighting each section. Click on the main panel. A pop-up window is displayed. When you selected the text area, the bot automatically recognized text area and asking you to provide the input text. On the pop-up window, you can see a text box, keyboard keystrokes, and two checkbox options, type password and empty field. If you check type password, it's considering your input as password. If you check empty field here, it will delete previously existing text. Type a custom text into text box. The right platform for learning RPA is HelloBridge YouTube channel, and press enter. The string is displayed in notepad. Now go to format menu, select font. The font window is displayed. Select a different font style such as bold italic. I will select any one of the font here. Then selecting my font style as bold and font size as 40, and click OK. Press escape button. You exit the recording view, then click on save and exit button to save your project, or press escape 2 times directly to save your project. Now your saved project is displayed in the designer panel. Here you can see different activities, that whatever steps you performed. Let's run the file to see the automated process. Go to design tab, debug file options, and select run file. Now you can see the automation is executing as expected for basic recording. Let's start desktop recording. Desktop, suitable for all types of desktop applications and multiple actions. It is faster than the basic recorder and generates a container with selector of top level window in which activity are enclosed and partial selectors for each activity. Go to new and select a sequence. Provide the sequence name as desktop, then click create. Now your sequence is ready. Follow the same steps that we did with the basic recording. Go to notepad, click on the main panel. A pop-up window is displayed. On the pop-up window, you can see a text box. Type a custom text into the text box. The right platform for learning RPA is HelloGrace YouTube channel and press enter. This string is displayed in the notepad. Go to format menu, select font. The font window is displayed. Here, select a different font style such as bold, italic, and font size and click OK. Press escape button. You exit the recording view, then click on save and exit button to save your project, or press escape 2 times directly to save your project. Now your saved project is displayed in the designer panel. Here you can see different activities that whatever steps you performed. Let's run the file to see the automated process. Go to design tab, debug file option and select run file. Now you can see the automation is executing as expected for desktop recording. Now you are asking yourself a bunch of questions, that what is container, what is selector, what is the difference between basic and desktop recording. I will show you with a practical example. Go to basic recording workflow page. Here you see there is no container, all the activity captured inside the sequence. Click on any one of the recorded activity and go to property panel. Go to the target option and click on it to expand. There are few options listed here. Click on selector. You will get selector editor pop-up window. Here you can see an edit selector portion. Whatever captured inside edit selector portion, it is called selector. Selectors are being used to target one or more HTML elements to apply CSS rules. Don't worry about that, it is all part of programming process. You can see in this selector, 3 lines are captured. The first line, we call it as top level window selector. Now click cancel. Go to other activity selector. Here also you can see the top level window selector at the first. Likewise, it generates a full selector for each activity. That is why the basic recorder automation is slower than desktop recorder. Let's go to desktop recording workflow. Here you can see all the activity captured into attached window container. Click on attached window container, then go to property panel and select selector. Here you can see the top level window selector from the attached window container. Then click cancel. Then select, type into activity and check selector. Only a partial selector for the type into activity can be seen here because the top level window selector is disabled. Likewise, all the activity captured partial selector. That is why the desktop recording is faster than the basic recording. Recap. Basic recording generates a full selector for each activity and no container. And desktop recording generates a partial selector for each activity with a container with the selector of top level window. And basic recording, the resulted automation is slower. And desktop recording, it is faster than the basic recorder. In the next video, I will cover the remaining recording types. Thanks for watching. Connect with us for more tutorials.